Citizens speak out. Protests continue to be made in both large and small measure as people call for governments in countries such as Algeria, Bahrain, China, Egypt, Côte d'Ivoire or Ivory Coast, Libya, Syria, the US and Yemen to respond with reforms to bring a new era of mutual respect, dignity and representation.
Following the urging by Egyptian citizens for the government to support the Palestinian people, the Jerusalem Post news agency reported that Egyptian officials said the construction of a steel wall along the border with Palestinian Gaza had been halted after President Hosni Mubarak resigned.
Zhu Yufu has become the fourth pro-democracy activist reported to be arrested in China after publishing a poem supporting online calls for protests, with others facing similar charges including Ding Mao, Yang Yunfei and Chen Wei.
As peace activists worldwide protested on the Global Day Against Military Spending on Tuesday, many US citizens rallied in front of the White House in the nation's capital of Washington, D.C.
After the attack of government forces resulted in the deaths of at least seven Yemeni protesters on Wednesday, the French Foreign Ministry called upon the government to protect demonstrators from harm and to uphold their civil and political rights, while also affirming that France does not provide any weaponry to Yemen that could be used for internal repression. Yemen's Attorney General Abdullah al-Aluvi demanded officials identify and prosecute those responsible for the deaths of 60 protesters during March, stating that he would resign if justice is not served.
After Syrian security forces went house to house in Baida, arresting an estimated 350 men under the age of 60, hundreds of Syrian women marched along the coastal highway demanding their release, as they also expressed their solidarity for citizens in the nearby town of Banyas, which had been similarly shut down by the nation's military. On Wednesday, at least two people were killed and 200 arrested.
Former Côte d'Ivoire President Laurent Gbagbo called for his supporters and those of President Ouattara to disarm and engage in dialogue to resolve all differences. The UN World Food Programme has also announced plans to deliver food aid in support of tens of thousands who have been displaced by months of conflict up to now.
After four Bahrainis died in government custody and their bodies were either not shown to family members or they were found to have the marks of severe abuse, US State Department spokesperson Mark Toner urged the government to ensure detainees' security and fair trials. Human Rights Watch called for an investigation into the deaths, also asking the Bahraini government to disclose the whereabouts of an estimated 800 arrested activists, as well as allowing them to contact family members and lawyers. The European Union donated $15 million to assist migrant workers seeking to leave Misurata and other areas of Libya that are still facing heavy bombardment by government forces. France also sent 9 tons of humanitarian aid to Benghazi as the Interim Transitional National Council formed a relief committee to work with the Libyan Red Crescent Society in addressing the needs of over 35,000 people fleeing conflict within the country.
We are saddened to know of the cherished lives lost as we look with hope toward the peace that is replacing turmoil in some countries and continue to pray that people everywhere choose harmonious coexistence with dignity and freedom for all.
In sorrowful response to these unfortunate world events, Supreme Master Qinghai lovingly reminds, "If the road is wrong, the more we walk on it, the more we go wrong. Any leaders who committed harm to others should stop at once, sincerely repent to God, and act to redeem their mistaken deeds. Then they will be pardoned. Even if humans can't forgive, heaven will."